Oh, he's getting the girls to come down. Yeah.
He needs to hurry.
Yeah. He told me make sure everybody stays. He's hurt. He said he was gonna be really quick. So.
Apparently, Uncle Doug's about to get married on the vacation.
This is your wedding.
Uncle Doug!
Put the camera down, Doug.
Put it down.
This is your wedding.
Watch up here, okay? Watch up here. Watch up on the step, okay?
Who does this? We do.
Oh, my God. Oh my God! Look at her!
Wow!
Oh wow!
Look up the look at these steps. Look at Angie. All right, look at Miss Angie.
Coming
down. Yes.
Yeah.
She's got a pretty dress on too. Look at her.
Oh,
beautiful.
Wow!
Look at her. Looking beautiful.
To celebrate the surprise wedding, Doug and Angela. would like to thank family and friends for allowing them to ambush this family reunion for their sharing this special day with them. The decision to become united in marriage has not been entered into lightly by either of them. It has apparently taken 12 and a half years and a 5-year engagement to make this finally happen. Good thing y'all have cameras out. This ceremony is brief compared to the days and years you will have together as a couple. Remember this day and all this family that surrounds you. Loving someone is a leap of faith. You are giving them your heart and trusting them not to break it. No matter what happens, never regret making that leap for one another. As an act of love and a blessing on this marriage, who presents this woman to be wed to this man?
Me, her sister, Kelly, who's here, Kristen, who would have been, but is not, and I.
Will you please join their hand? You got to give her a hug.
Thank you, James. Love you, man. There you go.
I belong in your arms. Finally, I have found a place into which I fit perfectly, safely, and securely, with no doubt and no fear. This place is filled with happiness and laughter, yet it is spacious enough to allow me the freedom to move around, to live my life and be myself. This wonderful place, which I never believed really existed, I have finally found inside your arms, inside your heart, inside your love. Doug and Angela, you both come here freely and without reservation to make public your love for one another. To be kind is more important than to be right. Many times what people need is not a brilliant mind that speaks, but a special heart that listens. Promising to talk through issues, having faith in one another, allowing each other to be yourselves, loving freely and without jealousy, giving and hoping, growing and loving, being there for one another through the tears and the laughter, and to be by each other's side for both now and forever.
You will.
Doug.
Look at how I'm marrying you.
Okay. Do you take Angela as your wife? Will you support her, encourage her, love her, be her shoulder to lean on, her hand to hold, and keep her in sickness and in health? Will you continue to be her best friend, her most admiring lover, and her dearest companion?
I will.
Angela!
I love the kids in the background.
They're excited too. Yeah. Do you take Doug as your husband? Will you support him, encourage him, love him, be his shoulder to lean on, his hand to hold, and keep him in sickness and in health? Will you continue to be his best friend, his most admiring lover, and his dearest companion?
Yeah.
They've been putting up with each other for 12 years. Above you are the stars. Below you are the stones. As time does pass, remember, like a star, your love should be constant. Like a stone, your love be firm. Be close. Be understanding. Have patience with each other.
Years of law in the face.
For storms will come, but they will go quickly. Be free and giving of affection and warmth. Have no fear, and do not let the ways of the world give you unease. Wedding vows are made between the groom and the bride as a public declaration of their love. They pledge to share their lives openly, to speak truth to one another, and promising to cherish each other as an individual for the rest of their lives. This commitment is made in love, kept in faith, lived in hope, and eternally made new. Doug, will you please read your vow to Angela?
This is where I get to say all the things, all the reasons why I love this girl so much. Everything she's done for me over these 12 years and supported me, and I just can't go on and on enough. So I'm going to read this to you. No, I'm not. If I know, I'm not. But that's how long it should be. I knew you the day I met you. And you know why. Thanks to Match.com. Our first date, within 1 hour, I knew I loved you. And after a very short time together, I knew. So, you know, I became a believer in love at first sight. That was the first time. After I knew you for a very short time, I became a believer in soulmates, because she is my soulmate. We fit so well together. We agree on everything together, which is hard to do, right? When we disagree, we find a way to agree. But I cannot, it's always that way. I cannot imagine my life in this world without you, Angela. And she always says, Angela dropped the A, she's an angel. So I believe she's an angel, almost an angel. She's my angel sent to me from God, and I believe that. And I'm glad to stand here today and marry her in front of all of my family and friends and take her for the rest of my life. I love you so much.
Okay, good job.
Angela, will you please read your vow to Doug?
I wrote mine.
Mine's over there.
Well, I never thought that a wink over the internet could bring me the love of my life. Oh, God. You are the one, because you are my best friend. You can always make me laugh. You understand me even when I don't hold credit, You can look at me in my weirdest moments and say, I love you. I love you so much, and I can't wait to have the rest of my life.
Doug, will you please repeat after me? I, Doug.
Thank you, Angela.
Thank you, Angela.
As my wife.
As my wife.
To love.
To love.
And cherish.
And cherish.
From this day forward.
From this day forward. Angela, will you please repeat after me? I, Angela.
Thank you, Doug.
Thank you, Doug.
As my husband.
To love.
To love.
And cherish.
And cherish.
From this day forward. The world knows by the outward symbol of the wedding ring that this couple has committed their lives as one. The unending circumference of the ring represents the unending love you both have for one another. Legend has it that this ring is worn on a finger that is connected to the heart. When you look at your wedding rings on your finger, remember the never-ending love that you both have for one another. Will you please place this ring on Angela's finger and repeat after me? With this ring, I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
I promise.
From this day forward,
you shall not walk alone.
You shall not walk alone.
May my heart?
Be your shelter.
And my arms?
Be your home.
Angela. Will you please place this ring on Doug's finger and repeat after me? With this ring,
I give you my heart.
I promise.
From this day forward,
you shall not walk alone. May my heart
be your shelter. And my arms
be your home. Doug and Angela, It started with a wink. And now you have made your commitment to one another during this wedding ceremony. The two of you have expressed your love, faithfulness, loyalty, and support by joining hands, reciting vows, and exchanging rings. Now, by the authority given me as by the laws of the state of Texas, I do hereby pronounce you husband and wife. Go on and kiss. It is now my pleasure to introduce you to Mr. and Mrs. Doug and Angela Hughes.
Sorry to mess up those barbecues.
Hey, the vintage
bird, man.
Little
impulse. Thanks, honey. What a surprise. What a
People ask me why. See, I kind of already knew that. I got.
Who does that?
Amazing how it all worked out.
We pulled it
off. That was incredible.
Do you?
She's a great grandchild.